Oh, I'm making frames for my wife, who's an artist, and for the small size paintings she does, she can't get these frames, or maybe I think something like $25 a piece. So I decided to try making frames myself, and I'm after some thought and going to Home Depot, we decided to make them out of corner molding, which seems to work pretty well, but there are some precautions that you have to take. Now, when I first started this, which 2 days ago, or a day ago, I first started, the first thing I noticed that it was absolutely almost impossible to get all these lengths exactly the same. I mean, I would measure each one and then put it in here and try to align the saw, and it would be a little bit longer, and I'd sand that. So finally, I looked at a lot of YouTube videos on how to do frames. Frankly, they weren't much help. I saw people measuring things to length and then lining up the line on a radial saw and then trimming it a little bit. And I didn't want to get into all that. So this is the system that I finally came up with, and it works beautifully. And I pass it on. If I have, for example, just any piece of scrap with the correct angle on it. All right, there's a piece of scrap with the correct angle on it. Then what I do is I just clamp it in here to get the length that I want. So my first cut is just the right, this angle, my first cut will be this angle, here. That will be my first cut. Now to do the second cut, the piece is clamped over here, but I've clamped it, you would clamp it here, then you would move that up till you were at the right distance. They don't match here, they match in here. Maybe my wife can get to this side here. I'll show you exactly what happens. After there's your, I'm not gonna go through the actual saw. You clamp your stock in here, all right, like that. Then I'll start with an actual piece. You clamp your stock in here like this, all right? And then you just cut a little piece off the end so that you're at the right angle that you want. Then you cut it off like that. After you cut it off, then you move it up into there. So now what you have, this is snugged up into there, and this cut now is exactly the same length. So then you finish off by cutting it to length that way. Now, for the next piece, you have to cut off the tip like this, and then shove it up to there, and then cut the next piece. As you can see, this is the other thing that I felt I had to do was to keep track of the number of I found that if I just took random pieces, the thicknesses wouldn't match correctly on the end where they butted together. So what I did was, I assumed that adjoining sections of the corner molding would fit together almost exactly. So I numbered the pieces, so I'm basically taking consecutive pieces of the molding. So there won't be much difference in thickness between here and here, here and here and here and here. So that's basically the whole system. And just a word, a safety issue. I should point out that I'm really not set up to be very safe here. I'm giving a bad example. I should have goggles on and a mask and a hearing stop, and I should, and then, you want to be very careful when you do this, because if you're not taking all these safety precautions, when you're cutting in the miter box, you could get sucked into that saw there, and terrible things could happen. So don't be as careless as I'm being. You see the problem here. There's the saw going back and forth, and I'm being, I have my finger close to it. So be a little more careful than I am, Ben. I hope this is useful to somebody. Finally, I might point out that, let's see if we can go over here and see how, pick a square here. And let's just see if we can do a comparison of the, Let's see, how do I have to, I don't know if these are adjoining people, but let's see, all right. How do I have to check it? It's so confusing on this here. Where are we? All right, this is how I have to check it. All right, so I'm gonna put this like that, and I put that like that. And as you can see, all right, can you get that? As you can see, we have a nice joint there. I mean, there it is, okay. You have to get a joint, there we go. There's a little fuzz on there from the cutoff, but basically, you can see on the ends and there, it's all done with the miter saw, which is a Husky miter saw. And finally, to put it together, you can see it on other YouTubes where they put down a strip of tape, then they put all the pieces together like that on the tape, then put glue on there, and then tie it up together. And finally, to hold it securely, I found that, where are my rubber bands here? Let me just look for my rubber, give me a minute to look for my rubber bands.
I think they're in the house.
They're in the house?
Good stuff.
All right, and now I'm just gonna say a few words on gluing it together. Remember, you've put a piece of tape underneath it, and after you've folded it up and with the corners glued, you're gonna have this piece of tape or pieces of tape all around. You can have glue coming out of here. And then the final thing to hold everything together, what I found works very nicely, you buy a bag of these rubber bands at Staples, and then you can put your whole, in a minute, you can clamp the whole frame up quite easily. And it works beautifully. Works beautifully. Okay, so there's the frame all glued up and drying. And then after it dries, you just flip off the rubber bands and you're finished. And then you sand it and touch it up a little. This isn't, you know, I'm not framing the Mona Lisa here. With the frame, my wife's artwork, which is almost the Mona Lisa. Just to demonstrate what the final application of this is. This is my first trial piece. Don't go on. This is the second one, which is a little bit. The purpose of the whole thing was to create a floating frame. The picture gets, Mother, you should have brought one of your pictures. I could have advertised it. Well, my wife does beautiful artwork. Yep, her name is Karen Hart. and this is the way the picture sits in the frame, all right? And then the way to attach it is you just put a couple screws in the back. Oh, and I should note that the stapler works wonderfully on that. Here, I'll just demonstrate how easy it is to do that. Just an ordinary stapler, household stapler. And there we are, we staple it. And then, you know, you could tap it in with a hammer so it's flush. But that's it, so... did I mention everything? Did I mention your artwork? I don't know. I used this glue. It works very well. I'm not in the advertising. Oh, and this here was I must say, this is a Husky. I'm not advertising. I'm not getting paid for anything. This is what I got locally. This is at the Home Depot. This is a Husky miter box and saw. And the precision is absolutely remarkable. And the box is $5. Like if it wears out after making 20 frames, you buy another box for $5. And the one thing that's touchy on the whole project is that this corner molding is $1.67 a foot. So you have to. So that's why you have to be very careful on how you pick your sizes and so on. Okay. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. Have a good day. I'm excited to go through to one piece just to, in real time. And so if you want to watch it, you can, or else you can cut off if you feel you've seen it all. This is the setup. You can see my scrap piece with the angle that I need. This is the molding here. Now, to begin with, I need my angle on that. Excuse me, Mother. All right, now I'm going to cut that piece through. All right. And here we go. Try to make it as fast as possible. And fortunately, I didn't get sucked into the miter saw. And I'm a little bit picky. You get sawdust in there, and that interferes with a good mate. So let me take this off. The other thing that interferes with a good mate is if you have a little fuzz on here. So I just sand the fuzz off so that doesn't... All right, then that gets pushed up into there like that. And it gets clamped into place like that. And now we do the other side of the frame piece like that. And that's it. So what you get is this, and it matches exactly to every other piece that I've done, and you can do that all afternoon. You can see the matching there. I can do that all afternoon, and then the gluing is going to be more of a pain. I can't think of a way to automate that right now, but that was the actual process of cutting a piece with the stop, illustrating the spot, the stop, and clamping things down. Thank you. Hope that's the end. Now, the piece that I've cut off won't match the frame. You have to think about the angles on that. But so the next, starting off the next piece, I just have to get the same starting angle again, which I do here like this. Oh, I should clamp that down. I'm not going to show the, I just want to show, I don't know if you can see it. You see, it won't match now because it's the wrong angle. So I have to put a new angle on. I have to start off with a fresh piece here, which I'll do like this. All right, and then I have to cut this off so I get my starting position again. All right, there, I've cut it off, cut that little edge off. I got a whole bunch of them laying around here. After I've done that, then I can just move it up, match it, and clamp it, and repeat the process. After you clean it up so it butts together well. Thank you, that's it.